Syrians have just re-elected Bashar al-Assad to be president for the fourth time. And the Western media has been calling it undemocratic because, as you know, any election that the CIA doesn't control is undemocratic. Right? The media talks about sham elections, but they can't even expand or elaborate what that even means. They just bring on a bunch of bitter exiles and opposition figures. How can you talk about the elections in Syria and not mention the fact that most Syrians actually support Bashar al-Assad, that he won in a landslide victory with 76% turnout? Some people think you can only say these things when you are a big fan of Assad. The concept of Syrian sovereignty, of respecting the will of the Syrians, does not even enter their brains. You had Syrians out celebrating in droves all over Syria. You don't think that's something you might want to mention? No, you don't think that's relevant to the topic? The media talks about Syrians suffering and living in poverty. Yeah, and why are they in poverty? Because Syria is under crippling sanctions imposed by the United States and the European Union. People are suffering because the West has been trying to destroy Syria for a decade. There were no bread lines in Syria before the war. You didn't have to wait 48 hours up to 2 days just to get fuel. That's a direct result of Western intervention and the West trying to topple the Syrian government. They say that only people in government-controlled areas are allowed to vote, as if the government is purposely excluding people from voting. Why don't you go ask Al-Qaeda why they don't have polling stations in Idlib? Yeah, why don't you go ask the Americans who are stealing the oil in northeastern Syria why there are no polling stations? Why don't you ask Canada, France, and Germany why they blocked Syrian citizens from going to vote in the Syrian embassy? All these Western countries were saying even before the election happened that they reject the results. First of all, this is not your country for you to reject the results. What do you think Syria is, a colony? Second of all, this shows that they do not care at all about what Syrians actually want. You know, they talk about democracy and then they deny Syrians the right to vote and participate in their own elections. Don't come here and talk to me about democracy. We saw the so-called democracy that America and Britain brought to Iraq. We saw the democracy that NATO brought to Libya and Afghanistan. We know what these people are. They are imperialists and colonizers. They continue to attack the Middle East, but occupy it under a different slogan or a different banner. The West doesn't even have democracy itself. How can you talk about democracy when you disenfranchise voters in the US? When the UK bans people from protesting and infiltrates activists with undercover police, when they jail journalists like Julian Assange? This is preposterous. Just look at how many countries they have destroyed and decimated. Look how many right-wing governments and bloody coups they have pulled in the Middle East and Africa and Latin America. Who are you to talk about democracy? Even after 10 years, all you hear is the same nonsense repackaged over and over. Oh, Assad used chemical weapons. They can't even say Syrian government or Syrian army. They have to say Assad regime or Syrian regime forces. Really? They had no problem with Bashar al-Assad 20 years ago when he was meeting with Tony Blair and the Queen of England and Nancy Pelosi. The West is so desperate to get rid of him, they're still peddling this lie about the Douma gas attack, which never took place. The scientists themselves from the OPCW went to Douma and found nothing, and the reports were doctored. Go read the emails on WikiLeaks, how they omitted the toxicology reports, how the so-called gas canister was manually placed there. How can anyone believe what Britain and America say about weapons of mass destruction after Iraq anyway? This is a massive propaganda effort to sell a war on Syria. The mainstream corporate media serves as the PR department of the national security state and the military-industrial complex. They want to convince you that right-wing jihadists are freedom fighters and that counterterrorism by Iran, Russia, and Syria is tyranny. You know, if Syrians didn't support Bashar al-Assad, how could he possibly have stayed in power for 10 years while a dozen countries and a dozen more terrorist groups are trying to get rid of him? Are you telling me he's Superman? Syrians support Bashar al-Assad because he stopped ISIS, because he stopped al-Qaeda from taking over the country. He stopped the West from turning Syria into another failed puppet state. And I know this might be hard to grasp for a lot of Westerners, but people in Syria do not want to live under the rule of HTS or other head-chopping lunatics funded by the CIA and MI6. Go look at how those so-called freedom fighters and moderate rebels treat women and religious and ethnic minorities, and what kind of elections they have. Syrians don't want some Al-Qaeda wonderland sponsored by Uncle Sam in Saudi Arabia, okay? Syrians want a secular, stable country that is multi-ethnic, multi-religious, and most importantly, one that isn't controlled by the West, okay? Syrians want a country that stands with Palestinians and with the resistance. This election, Syrians have again sent the world a message that we will not allow colonial powers like the French and the British and the Americans to control our political affairs, our resources, our society. The regime change project in Syria has failed, and Syrians have said no to imperialism.